This is a complete schematic diagram of the RF section. There are two boards. The first board here is the modulation board. As you can see, there is a tropical fish capacitor here, one zener diode, two resistors, one diode here, and one capacitor here, a tantalum capacitor. And there are two trimmers here. Okay, so this is the modulation board. The input is here. There is a shock inductor. There is a trimmer here in series, which permits to adjust probably the modulation depth. There is a capacitor in series. Okay, and this transistor is a modulation transistor, actually. The oscillator is here. It uses a single transistor, VT9, which is a 2N3375. And this transistor is in common base configuration. The input is on the emitter here. There is an LC network here, which permits the oscillation. We can see here the inductance L6. The bias current is adjustable by this trimmer here. There is a zener diode here, which permits to reduce the voltage at approximately 10 volts on that point. The output is on the collector here. So you can see that we have this capacitor C7, which is connected between the output and the ground. And we can see this capacitor here. The value of this capacitor is 10 nanofarads. CK06 ceramic capacitor. So we can see here the impedance curve of this capacitor, which is this one here. So at a frequency of 450 MHz, the capacitor is inductive actually. Okay, the impedance is approximately 10 ohms, and we need to add also several ohms due to the leads of this capacitor. So at the output, there is a tuning circuit. The maximum gain can be adjusted using this trimmer capacitor C22. I have connected the RF module here to this spectrum analyzer. There is an attenuator of 40 dB here. I have connected also the modulation input here to this function generator here. Currently, the frequency is 40 kHz square wave. Okay, we can see that the maximum power here is minus 10 dBm. So therefore, the output power here is approximately 30 dBm, that is to say 1 watt. Okay, you can see that the frequency here is approximately 442 MHz. Okay, so we can see that we can change the frequency. And that's all for this telemetry transmitter. Thank you for watching and see you next time for another video. Bye bye.